Hello, everybody, and welcome to Downtown Network. I'm your host, Downtown Chris Brown, and tonight we do our live stream of WWE SummerSlam 2K14, where we will basically go through all the SummerSlam matches you will see this Sunday on pay-per-view and the WWE Network for, that's right, $9.99. God, I am so sick of hearing about that on Monday Night Raw. How I long for the Attitude Era. How I really long for that. But basically, yeah, I'm going to share my opinions on who I think is going to win each match, and we're going to go through each match here, and yeah, it should be a good time. So our first matchup here tonight is Chris Jericho versus Bray Wyatt. This is sort of a spillover of a rivalry from last month's pay-per-view Battleground, where Chris Jericho picked up a victory over Bray Wyatt. So let's see what happens right now here on Downtown Network. It's Bray Wyatt versus Chris Jericho next.
Approaching the ring, representing the family from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Brad Wyatt.
Wow, listen to that reaction.
All right, folks, here we go. So we got Bray Wyatt versus Chris Jericho here. Who do I think's going to win? Well, I'm playing as Bray Wyatt because I believe that Bray needs to win a matchup at a pay-per-view this year. He's only won at pretty much the Royal Rumble and Extreme Rules, but Extreme Rules was even kind of a wonky one with the little kid singing to John Cena with the cage match. But so yeah, I really think Bray Wyatt needs to get a win here to legitimize his cause. And he can make a big name for himself if he does it at a major four pay-per-view like SummerSlam. He swung wild with that one. So I want to hear what you guys think in the chat. Who do you think is going to win? I did see a few people saying Bray Wyatt is going to win, which I agree with you. Oh, belly to back suplex to Chris Jericho. There's going to be a lot of offense in this match. Into the collar and elbow tie-up. Only one can come out ahead. Big elbow.
That was a ton of velocity. What impact? And his drop kick. What impact? A swift kick. Escape that one.
SummerSlam is Jericho, so I guess I have a vote for Chris Jericho. Oh, damn. I didn't know Bray Wyatt had that move in this game. Haha, nice. That was like a modified wasteland that Wade Barrett uses. Bad news, Barrett. I'm afraid I have some bad news. Jericho taking a lot of damage here. Don't count him out just yet. If he locks in one of those submission holds, this match could just about be over. Which match am I looking forward to most? Definitely Brock versus Cena, because I want to see Brock just absolutely annihilate him. If you can't tell, I have my Eat, Sleep, Break the Streak t-shirt on. Couldn't remember if I had Eat, Sleep, Conquer. So yeah, I'm really hoping that Brock Lesnar wins the title at SummerSlam. I think that'll definitely lead into some really like hardcore matches in the months to come if he keeps the title that long. Could you imagine Brock Lesnar going into Hell in a Cell with the WWE title, whoever he would face? That would be crazy. Especially if he goes in, maybe Daniel Bryan returns? Who knows? But yeah. We'll get to that stuff later, though, I think, in the Brock match. The Eater of Worlds! Oh! Countered! Countered by Jericho. I can't get my signature on Jericho. Exit, exit. Oh, damn! Bulldog on the outside! Oh, into the post! And we're getting a little hardcore now. German suplex on the outside! Oh, quit doing that to me. Dude, he just keeps hammering me over and over again. I can't do anything. Oh, my God. I'm going to count it out. No. Oh, no. Sister Abigail. One, two, three. Bray Wyatt wins. You heard that Brock is going to break Cena's arm. Hey, that would be nice because I'm a little tired of Cena being on TV all the time. And, you know, we need some new rivalries, some new characters, you know. WWE's just really stale.
Here is your winner, representing your family. Representing the family.
We knew he felt he had to win this one tonight. There's absolutely no way to underscore how big this victory is.
Good night from SummerSlam.
Good night from SummerSlam.
All right, guys, I'm going to get the next matchup set up, so I will return with the next matchup.
The following contest is a ladder match. Making his way to the ring, from Bulgaria, Alexander Rushin.
Oh, the WWE Universe letting him hear it.
Approaching the ring, from Perry, Oklahoma, weighing 263 pounds, the All-American American, Jack Swagger.
Swagger's a two-time NCAA All-American, a world champ, and an ECW champ. You can say he's
All right, guys, we got Jack Swagger and Rusev in a flag match at the real SummerSlam, but since they don't have flag matches in WWE 2K14, I figured they got to climb something, right, to get the flag, so why not a ladder? Sure. I think that because WWE has such a hard-on with this Russia versus USA tensions going on in the real world, and they have a lot of confidence, I guess you could say, in Rusev. I think Rusev's going to defeat Jack Swagger at SummerSlam to further continue his streak of dominance through the WWE roster. I don't think Jack Swagger's going to be the guy that really ends Rusev and his like undefeated streak. I just don't see it. But I have seen a few of the We the People chants and thinking Jack Swagger's going to be victorious, and we'll have to see this Sunday, but I really doubt it. Whoa! Uh-oh. Ow. That was a hardcore clothesline there. Oh, snap. Oh, snap. Oh, through the table.
I love watching these replays.
Oh, snap. Run, Rusev.
Man, I thought he was done for. It looks like he's setting the ladder up in the corner. There's going to be a lot of offense in this match.
Oh, shit. Sorry, guys, if I don't get to your comments right away, because it's hard for me to, like, look over at the computer and give you a good match at the same time. But I will definitely get to your comments here. Oh, damn. Ow. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Get up. Oh, my God. Oh! Hell with it. We're going to set up four corners of ladders. No, 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 not that. Oh, shit. Yeah, come on out. Oh, he's busted open.
Jack Swagger took some shot to the head. He's now covered in blood.
What can Swagger do here, Kate?
Well, on paper, they matched up evenly.
My God in heaven.
What in the world? What's he planning with that ladder?
Slam is?
You know what my favorite part of SummerSlam is? Here we get the Divas. Every year we get to see Divas in bikinis. He was, I love it.
Swagger
was stepping ahead on that one. Swagger is so.
Oh my God, he's in a powerbomb through the ladder! What the hell? He missed the ladder.
What a match.
Oh, he didn't miss it that time. Oh, shit. I thought he was going to put me through the ladder. The way that it was laying that way. Snap.
Jack Swagger considers himself to be the best of the best. His sensational arsenal makes it only a matter of time before WWE Gold is around him.
Oh no. Counter by Jack Swagger.
Whoa, that was some reversal by Swagger.
Now Rusev. Oh, snap.
The physicality of the bruiser.
What the hell is Rusev doing? Oh my God, what the hell is he doing? Oh my God! He was trying to land on Jack Swagger.
Risks have been taken.
Risks have been taken. Bodies that crash converge. And still that prize dangles high above the ring. The physicality. He can bit second. Oh, stopped at the last second.
I was hoping he would climb the ladder.
Who has what it takes to bring it down?
What the hell is he doing?
Oh, right into the ladder.
Oh my God.
He's got him.
Oh.
Yes, looks like a superplex. Here it is. Back into the ring now.
WWE, we're in the midst of WWE. Match. If things are about to get it, he's heading up the ladder.
Come on, Jack. Come on, Jack. You're gonna die, Jack. Goodbye, Jack. Oh my God. Oh, to the ladder! That's it. It's over. That was hardcore ending there. Now that's the spot you end with, baby. Rusev Crash! Somebody said it should have been a submission match, but they wouldn't let Rusev lose like that, which is why it's a flag match. That's a good point. I didn't actually make Rusev. I got that from the community. The community creations. I downloaded it. In terms of the Stephanie and Brie match, we'll get to that later on in the stream. I don't want to spoil my thoughts on that. Rusev will lose, but still never be pinned or submitted. But didn't Rusev lose last month at the last pay-per-view? That's why I'm questioning why you think Rusev's going to win. Didn't Rusev lose by disqualification to Jack Swagger? I thought he did, but maybe I'm wrong. If you were to book the ending, Swagger gets multiple ankle locks, Rusev can't climb to get the flag, and Swagger wins, then rematch would be a submission match. Interesting. Yeah, I think a submission match between those two would be awesome. All right, guys. Well, hey, I'm going to take a little break here. I'm going to get to the next matchup, build it, and yeah, I will return after this.
contest is an Extreme Rules match. Making his way to the ring, from Davenport, Iowa, 109 pounds, Seth Rollins.
And we are hearing some love for this superstar here.
Approaching the ring, from Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing 215 pounds, Dean Ambrose.
Man, this Dean Ambrose, he gives me the creeps.
All right, so the two former Shield members are going to get it on here at SummerSlam, Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins. I've been waiting for like a real matchup between these two for quite some time. I thought we were going to get it last month, but then they did that weird thing where they didn't have a match, and then they kind of did have a brawl, but not really an official match. But we're finally going to get a real match. Unfortunately, it's a lumberjack match, which I really don't think fits these two guys at all. You really need to like let them loose and let them go at each other, which is why I picked an Extreme Rules match, because I felt that that would probably be a better match to watch. Not to mention a lumberjack match is not a setting in WWE 2K14. But I think Dean Ambrose is gonna finally get his revenge on Seth Rollins here and pick up the win. But you never know. I mean, the authority could once again screw over Dean Ambrose with the lumberjacks. You know, like pay the lumberjacks a certain amount of money to take out Dean Ambrose when he flies out of the ring. I don't know. Something stupid. They've screwed Dean Ambrose so many pay-per-views in a row that I feel like he kind of is deserving of a match to win at a pay-per-view, so... I don't know, what do you guys think? Yes, I am Dean.
You have to be ready for anything with Dean Ambrose.
That's the second time tonight that that's happened to me, where I try to like hit them into the table and they pull down the rope. Son of a bitch.
Everything is legal.
Oh my gosh.
Here we go. Let's bring out some toys. Damn. Dean is fucking psychotic, man. Hit him with the bell. Yeah. Damn. Have no mercy. Punish him. Oh, Russian leg sweep!
Wow. That's using your imagination.
Listen to listen to this arena. All the hardcore people are getting what they want tonight.
I don't know what that was, but okay. It was effective. He couldn't get his weapon. Oh, damn. I refuse to let you get a weapon, Seth Rollins. Damn it. I think he's finally going to get a weapon now. I can't get up. Oh, snap. Oh! But thanks for bringing the weapon out just to give it to me. Uh-oh. This is awesome! Couldn't you imagine this kind of a matchup between these two? Just beat the hell out of each other with weapons? That would be the shit. Oh no! Oh no! Through the barricade! These guys are tearing down the house tonight! Oops. What a wedge. Oh my god, he's got a sledgehammer. Trash can. Oh snap. Oh no. Oh! I jammed the sledgehammer up your ass. Whoa. He threw the trash can over top of my head. Okay, he totally kicked me in the face there, but it didn't even register. That's funny. Oh. Are we finally going to bring the action back to the ring?
It's not wise to get on the bad side of a man like Dean Ambrose.
Oh, snap. How dare you? Damn it. Quit countering, you son of a bitch. Yeah! Keep taking it from each other! Yeah! Oh no! Oh, I went through to my own table! Or, not table, chair! You missed, bitch. Yeah! Oh my god, what the hell is Dean Ambrose getting now? The steel steps! Holy shit. Oh!
Those steel steps getting used now as a weapon. Nobody's going to be the same after this match.
At some point this would happen. You had to think at some point this would happen. At some point, Ambrose would weaken.
Shot to the midsection.
Huge shot to the midsection.
Oh! One, two... Dean Ambrose wins. I was trying to do that move through the stairs, but nah.
And here's just some of the action we saw here.
Yeah, I don't think anybody's ever seen a good lumberjack match, honestly. Those matches need to be for, like, Raw and SmackDown. It's just a way for the WWE to get all their people into the pay-per-view, basically, because it's SummerSlam. It's just like how they do a bunch of Battle Royals and, like, WrestleMania and stuff, just to, like, showcase their current roster set. I just wish it wouldn't have been at the cost of the Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins match, but who knows, it could be a really good match. Alright guys, well hey, we'll get the next match set up, and I will return in just a bit.
opponent. From England, Paige.
Oh, the WWE Universe letting them hear it.
All right, guys, Divas title match here against the frenemies, AJ Lee and Paige. And I don't know about you guys, but I've really been enjoying the Divas matches as of late. I think that, especially these two, they're pretty good Divas wrestlers compared to some of the crap we've gotten in recent years. But, I think AJ will retain her title. After all the BS that Paige has been putting AJ Lee through, even injuring her by throwing her over, off of the stage on the one edition of SmackDown. So I think this will be the night that AJ gets revenge and retains her title. Don't know if this will actually end their feud. Maybe AJ will move on to a different diva to feud with. And maybe Paige then can build up her character a little bit more against somebody else as well. What do you guys think? Who do you think will win the matchup at SummerSlam? Do you picking AJ, CM Punk's wife? Or are you picking the anti-diva Paige? How does she kick me to the lower level and then kick? Oh, damn, quit throwing my head into the turnbuckle. Stop it. Ow. Did she just stone cold me? She just stone cold Steve Austin, stomped a mud hole in my ass and walked it dry and then flipped me off. Wouldn't that be awesome if she did that in real life? That would be great. Quit countering my freaking Hurricane Rana with power bombs. Oh, baby! You watch, this matchup will get the biggest amount of hits on my YouTube channel, just like last month. Seriously, I put every one of my matches into separate YouTube videos last month. The AJ and Paige match got the most hits. I wonder why, you pervs out there. I can't believe you would actually enjoy... See, I bet you enjoyed that move. You guys really enjoy the wrestling? Yeah, well... Who are you fooling? Come on. AJ Lee is laying the smacketh down. Oh, damn, she nipped up. How did she nip up? And how do I not have a signature? There we go. Okay, I have a signature. Boom! Come on, baby. Yeah. Uh-oh. Tap out! Tap out! I might lose this match. Oh no. Because she has a finisher and I don't. This isn't good. Oh no. Oof. Uh-oh. Oh. No. I countered the finisher. Oh, and she gets dumped to the outside. What are you doing, Paige? Oh, I thought I was going to get it through the steps. Hurricane Rana. You know what? I'm going to send... Get out of here. Ow! Ow! In the face! Oh my god. Oh damn! Yeah, I don't think we're gonna get this kind of quality matchup from the women on Sunday, but I could always dream, right? How long was I outside the ring and... Oh, man, she wants to go back out again. Okay, fine, yeah, we'll go back out again. Woohoo! Yeah, see, I learned my lesson here. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, slap her in the face. Oh, roll up! One, two, he got her! Woohoo! AJ retains the title with a small package. I kind of have a big package watching her, but you didn't hear that from me. Did the stream freeze for somebody? Somebody's saying that it froze, but I'm not seeing it on my side. Meanwhile, CM Punk is sitting at home watching. Yay! Yay, AJ! Oh, and for the guy that said that... Well, I saw something about CM Punk coming back in the comments. You hope that Punk comes back on Monday and challenges Brock Lesnar. Well, who wouldn't want that, right? Come on, man. But it's not going to happen. Didn't you hear him? He's never, ever coming back again. Never, ever, 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 ever. Unless you're playing WWE 2K15, in which case he is one of the main rivalries in the showcase. But hey, we'll get to that and much more coming up next in the next matchup. Let me get it set up for you, and I will be back after this. All right, guys, so we've got the Intercontinental title match now with The Miz and Dolph Ziggler. After The Miz essentially screwed over Dolph Ziggler in a battle royal for the vacated Intercontinental title after Bad News Barrett got injured with a shoulder injury, The Miz sort of laid out, you know, outside the ring throughout the whole battle royal. Everybody forgot about him. And then he came back at the very last second when Dolph had thought he won the battle royal and threw him over the top rope. And everybody was pissed. Including myself, because I really want them to finally push Dolph Ziggler. He's an awesome wrestler. He sells moves like crazy. And I just wish that he would get the push that he deserves. Unfortunately, I know, guys, I'm playing as The Miz. So I think The Miz is going to win at SummerSlam to sort of continue this feud. I think maybe Dolph Ziggler could potentially win the title at Night of Champions in September in a rematch. But, oh, damn, he's fame-mastering me all over the damn ring. But, yeah, I feel like The Miz, you know, not being a transitional champion, won't lose his title right away. They're going to keep this whole thing of, you know, teasing you with a Dolph Ziggler push a little bit longer. Dolph is kicking my freaking ass in this match. So who do you guys think is going to win at SummerSlam, Dolph or The Miz? Leave your comments in the chat and we will find out what you guys pick after this matchup. I still, like, people always say that they hate The Miz, but I really think that he could be, like, the next generation Chris Jericho, like, once Jericho is, like, officially done. I don't know, he just seems to have that same persona that Jericho used to have in WCW, where he's, like, the annoying pain in the ass. But I gotta admit, The Miz has gotten much better in the ring than he used to be. He used to be really bad. But by far, I think Dolph Ziggler is the superior wrestler, for sure, without question. Reversal after reversal here. There's the reversal. And here's the reversal. And another fame master. Oh, snap. Oh, DDT on the mats on the outside. Uh-oh. Dolph is looking to capitalize here and potentially win. Oh, no. We're going for the table again tonight. Oh! And The Miz goes through the laptop table and all. And is the laptop is through his foot. He's got the laptop stuck to his foot. He office spaced that laptop. Oh! Zigzag! Could this be my first loss of the night? Come on, kick out. No! He won the Intercontinental belt from me! I didn't use resiliency. Whoops. I was too enamored by the fact that the laptop went through his foot. I was distracted. Yeah, that's my excuse. There you go, your new Intercontinental champ, Dolph Ziggler. It could happen at SummerSlam. Not saying it's completely impossible. I just feel that The Miz will, you know, carry the feud a little bit longer, potentially into the next pay-per-view. But I think at some point, now seeing that the Intercontinental title is sort of like the second greatest title right now in WWE, Dolph's going to get that title at some point, I do think. All right, let's go to your comments. Man, a lot from Angel here. Boo, he hates The Miz. Yeah, me too. He loves RVD. Likes ladder matches, yeah. Yeah, in terms of Dolph Ziggler, they said, I know, right? They make him look like he sucks, but he does not suck. He doesn't suck, no. It was because he was injury prone so much and he was getting like concussions out the ass like all the time. And they thought he was like really prone to concussions, but you know, he's been on a roll for a while now, and I think they need to give him another shot. I mean, injuries happen. It's wrestling. And yeah, pretty much everybody is like rooting for Ziggler, which, you know, I totally agree with. So yeah. I'm going to get the next match rolling here, and I'll be back after this. All right, guys, Roman Reigns and Randy Orton will really continue their feud at SummerSlam, but this time in a one-on-one match, Authority versus Roman Reigns. I feel like Roman Reigns is going to finally, you know, he's getting the push right now, so I think Randy's going to let him go over at a big event like SummerSlam. They've been kind of pushing Roman Reigns ever since the Royal Rumble, really, where he was second to Batista. Oh, nice Samoan drop by Roman Reigns. He just pulled a nature boy. Oh, damn. Hell with the super punch. What about the super kick? The hell? He like no-sold that. Dolph Ziggler actually beat me in the previous matchup. Somebody wanted to know who won between The Miz and Dolph Ziggler. Yeah, that was the first match I lost of the night. Oh my God, Roman Reigns is going up top. He's waiting for Randy. That's all he has is an axe handle. Come on, man. Superman punch! Uh-oh. Yeah, I don't think so, Randy. Ooh-roh! Uh-oh. Randy, look out! Oh, my God! He speared him halfway across the freaking ring! Yeah. Randy got his ass whooped. Believe that. So who do you guys think is going to win The Miz versus... Roman Reigns... Blooper reel, Roman Reigns versus Randy Orton. Who do you guys think is going to win that match? I was reading about The Miz in the comments, and that's why The Miz entered my brain.
Here is your winner, Roman Reigns. He gets a big victory here tonight. Love him or hate him, that's an incredible match. Good night from SummerSlam.
Yeah, I got a vote for Roman winning, so I agree. All right, guys, we only got two matches left tonight. So stick around. I will be back right after this. All right, guys, the battle of the bitches is underway, the one you've been waiting for, right? Stephanie McMahon taking on Daniel Bryan's wife, Brie Bella. An interesting wrinkle in this matchup as of last Monday in that Stephanie is now trying to get some mistress to rattle Brie Bella. Somebody's having an affair, the physical therapist. Feels like a bad soap opera. Is the Attitude Era back yet? I really think that there's going to be a swerve in the match. I think Nikki Bella is going to be pissed off at her sister for no good reason other than that Stephanie has been beating the hell out of her since her sister had quit WWE. Maybe thinking that her sister indeed did abandon her. And I think Stephanie has gotten to Nikki Bella, and I think Nikki Bella will swerve us, will turn heel at SummerSlam and cost Brie Bella the matchup. Thus, Stephanie McMahon will be your victor.
Michael, I love Diva matches. No, I hope Heaven is kind of...
There's the submission. She might have no choice but to tap. Watch out here, ladies and gentlemen. Stephanie McMahon looks to be in trouble. She's got to find a way to regain her momentum.
Come on, Stephanie, you can do it. MILF power. Yeah, that's right. Uh-oh. Ow. Run.
Rolling out of harm's way. Smart strategy there.
Stephanie has really had her bell rung.
Yeah. She no-sold that.
Look at these two jockey for position. Uh-oh.
Ow. Run. Ow. She's countering everything. She's too powerful. Daniel Bryan has taught her too well. Oh, God. Oh, God. What is she doing? Stop running at me. Oh, my God. How many matches are going to involve the announce table tonight? Stephanie with the spot of the night. Look out. Little Nate. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Stephanie McMahon. Moonsault.
That's how you put an opponent away for good.
Look at Jerry. Look at Jerry's reaction. Oh, that damnable laptop again. It's that old general manager laptop. That's what it is. He keeps wanting to eat everybody's feet and hands. Stephanie, go for the cover. Screw it. One. No. Damn it. It's your only hope. Yeah. Hit her.
And the flow of this match has changed once again. What a kick that was.
Am I telling that deal? Oh, God. What are you doing? No, don't do that. What the hell is this? She cheated to win. Okay, I lost two matches tonight now. Little Nate, look at her feet! Yeah, oversold. You got that right, Percy. Oversold. Oh, my. But yeah, like I said before, I think Stephanie's going to win this match after Nikki swerves. You're not going to see this little reunion at the end of the match, I don't think. But hey, guys, coming up next, the one you've been waiting for real this time. Brock Lesnar versus John Cena for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. The Beast is back. Keep it right here on Downtown Network. It's coming up next.
following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the WWE Championship.
Introducing the challenger from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 287 pounds, Brock Lesnar. And his opponent from West Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing 240 pounds, he is the WWE Champion, John Cena.
All right, guys, the big one, Lesnar and Cena. I think this is the night that Brock Lesnar becomes the World Heavyweight Champion of the WWE. I can't wait for this match. I hope it's epic like their 2012 Extreme Rules match. That was just an awesome match. You never know. There may actually be blood in this matchup. It could be really brutal. I mean, Brock did talk about blood and vomit and urine. We could see all three this Sunday. You don't know. I don't know. It seems to me that WWE's been getting a little bit edgier with their content lately. I mean, they've been throwing around the word bitch and ass a lot. Swearing. Lesnar, man, he was saying F-bombs and they were bleeping them out in a little video package, too. And there's been a little bit more of a hardcore tone to WWE as of late. Maybe they're finally giving the fans what they want, but I don't know. Who do you guys think is going to win between Lesnar and Cena? Oh, man, through the steps. Oh my God. Oh, into the steel steps on the outside. For the love of God, Brock Lesnar just killed John Cena on the steel.
Lesnar at times can channel his rage, and other times he lets it possess him.
Somebody did tell me that I forgot Paul Heyman.
I'm sorry, guys. That was totally my bad. Paul Heyman will definitely have an impact this Sunday for sure, being one of the best managers. Best advocates of a superstar in WWE history. So that was just my bad, not including him. But in terms of the WWE game, I don't think he would impact the match that much.
So much on the line in this one. Like they say, on any given night,
Brock Lesnar manhandling John Cena. Oh my God, now what's Lesnar doing? Jesus Christ!
I think after that, I'd be searching in my tights for a white flag I could wave.
Lesnar almost threw John Cena in through Little Nate. Oh, and John Cena counters with an awesome hip toss. Oh, damn. John Cena now.
He plants him down with authority. That'll leave a mark.
I cannot counter his goddamn punches.
That'll leave a mark. Oh, the punch connects.
God damn it.
John Cena.
Stop it.
The top of the WWE, and he's
determined. You're making Brock Lesnar fucking angry.
At stake, you know these superstars will get everything they have.
You son of a bitch.
He drops the elbow.
Bah.
Look at him unloading with the Dez press. Huge power move. Oh, right to the gut.
How was that too late? I am hitting the button right on.
Throughout John Cena's career, he's never quit. No matter how tired he is, no matter how bruised and battered he is, John Cena keeps going. The championship hangs in the balance. Ow! What an elbow! Nice reversal. And he gets out of the way. And he tosses his opponent to the ground. And he reversed it! Good move there! And there's the reversal.
Damn you, John Cena, quit countering.
Electric for John Cena.
Yes.
Is so fast for a big man. What a counter.
Break him. Break him.
Very, very painful hold here. What's he gonna do? He's trying to
use your UFC skills. Oh, into the steel steps on the outside now.
The championship hangs in the balance. Cena countered it. A textbook reversal. Can he follow up?
Oh, again onto the steel steps on the other side now. For the love of God.
He saw that one coming. Four. Look out, Brock. Uh-oh. Wow. Explosive. Look how explosive Cena is. And I think he's begging him to bring it.
Six.
There's so many impressive things about John Cena.
Come on, man.
Back in the ring right now. He's putting those educated feet to good use. That elbow did some damage.
Oh, God. Here he goes with his punches again. Damn it.
He's got him up. Wait a minute. Look at this big body slam here.
Are you serious? Uh-oh. Five knuckle shuffle off the top row. Oh, my God. He hit it.
Five knuckle shuffle.
Oh my God. No. Damn it, John Cena. You're much of a pain in the ass as you are in real life. Son of a... This is not representative of what's going to happen at SummerSlam. What the fuck is he doing with me? Let me go.
Into the tie-up. Who's going to get the upper hand?
Getting your spine adjusted. Jeez, we're up to seven.
And he's heading back in. And they may have made a mistake thinking that Lesnar was finished.
Oh, jeez. You know, these competitors are so evenly matched, I wouldn't even begin to guess.
Dude, everything can't be too late or too early, for fuck's sake.
Again, the championship title at stake in this contest.
Lesnar does suck. Oh my God! He countered! He countered! Oh! He countered the F5! Oh my God! Oh my God! John Cena! He's got John Cena! F5! Could that be it? Rope break!
Into the ropes. And only a one count.
Oh! And he flips Cena inside out.
Back to the handoff, an explosive German suplex.
Oh, damn!
Lesnar is so fast for a big man. What a counter.
Please, they're not going to be rooting for Cena.
Displayed there. He gets out of trouble there. Got the arm up.
Yeah, there we go. There we go, Lesnar. Take it to him. Take it to him, Lesnar. Get him. Damn it. No. No. Bad Cena.
Quicker on that exchange.
Look at that counter from Lesnar.
Now break your goddamn arm. Oh, are you serious? He gets a comeback? After all the bullshit I've been through this whole matchup?
I don't know what's more intimidating. Brock Lesnar's power.
Kill him!
Ooh, a little showboating going on here.
Damn it. No.
What a move.
You son of a bitch. Go to hell. You no good Superman bastard. Yeah! Get him! Get him! Yes! F5 again! Christ. One count. What the hell is with that?
What a night it's been here at SummerSlam, and things only continue to get hotter.
John Cena, you are a bastard. No selling that F5.
There he goes again. No block. Lesnar has an athletic advantage over virtually every superstar he faces.
Oh, right into that ring post.
Yeah. Get him.
This one's for the most coveted prize in sports entertainment.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God!
Oh, my. Through the table.
What the hell is Lesnar doing?
Back into the ring now. John Cena running on fumes, but he's still running.
Little Nate picked up the stairs.
Side of that one.
Oh shit.
Oh, what a knee.
The WWE Championship is on the line.
Cena just one heartbeat quicker on that exchange.
Great reversal.
Whoa, now that's getting
God damn it.
To the canvas. And he gets to the ropes. These athletes seem
Come
to
on.
Have tried everything in their playbook.
Oh, there's more in their arsenal.
Oh, small package! I don't know what One! Happens, two! No!
This Brock Lesnar guy may physically be on a completely different level than anybody else I've ever met. You know what my favorite part of the SummerSlam is?
Tap out! Tap out! Give up!
What do you say, Cena?
The destruction we're seeing. I don't believe the destruction we're seeing.
This guy's just going from one painful move to another. Good grief!
Oh, what the hell is Lesnar doing? Oh my God.
Referee is out of it. Doing whatever it takes to win. There is nothing more destructive than the man beast Brock Lesnar.
Ah, God damn you, little Nate! I want to do an awesome spot here, and you're not letting me. You're being a dick.
This is a grueling championship match. Nobody wants to lose this.
Oh my God!
Oh, he's in trouble now.
F5 coming, third one! Oh my God!
F5 connects, and that has to be it.
One, two, three! Brock Lesnar is champion! I wanted to do an F5 onto the steel steps, but little Nate was being an asshole and throwing the steps out of the ring. So guys, who do you think's going to win? Lesnar versus John Cena. I'm picking Lesnar. But many people are saying possibly that Brock Lesnar could break John Cena's arm this Sunday at SummerSlam, thus sort of kicking him out of the picture of WWE for a little while he reigns supreme. Could that indeed happen? We'll find out. I kind of hope that it does, because I'm getting a little tired of Cena, and I want to see some Lesnar awesomeness on Raw and SmackDown each week with the WWE title. Well, guys, this has been my live stream of WWE SummerSlam. If you enjoyed what you saw here and you want to see more of my content, go ahead and subscribe to me on YouTube, and you can go ahead and like my Facebook and follow me on Twitter as well. You can see that stuff up at the top. SummerSlam this Sunday on the WWE Network for $9.99. Get it, because it's going to be awesome. Lesnar, Cena, this Sunday. This is Downtown Chris Brown signing off. I will see you next time. Same downtown time, same downtown channel. Take it easy.